In this video, we will create a basic Kivy application. We'll look at different layout types and widgets in Kivy. And now I'm going to create a most minimal Kivy application. Main.py. Here from Kivy app, import the app class. Then I'm creating an instance of the app class app and call the run method. This is the basic construction that I'm sure you have seen earlier. It looks like Flask applications that are created the same way. Now, with its default parameters, the instance of the app class just provides a creation of a window instance and nothing more. So we can expect a black window. Let's run it. Okay, we got the black window. All controls, buttons, labels, text inputs, checkboxes, and others are widgets in Kivy framework. And now I want to import the button widget, and I repeat a test application from the video about the installation process. Here, from Kivy UIX button, import the button class. And as usual, to change the class behavior, we have to create a child class that will inherit its properties from the parent class, that is, from the app class. Delete it. Class myApp that inherits from the app class devbuildSelf return the button instance with text parameter equals to hello world. Here my app instance small letter our huge button. What the build method does here? The only thing that the build method does, it places at least one widget on a window. By default, the build method places on a window an instance of the base widget class. That is why we have seen only black window in the first version. In this variant, I have overrided the build method and I forced it to return an instance of the button widget that was placed on a window by the run method. Actually, the build method can return only one widget, but for an implementation of any, even simple, user interface, we want to have several controls, like button, text input, or label, or something else. And to implement interfaces, we have to place our controls, widgets, on a special widgets that are called layouts. Layouts play role of a platform or a surface on which we are placing our user interface controls. To visualize the idea of using layouts, I have prepared some pictures. One of prototyping methods of UI and UX designers is implementation of an interface with paper prototypes. And a paper sheet on which UI controls are sticked in Kivy terminology are layouts. Basic function of Kivy layouts is to be a surface for other widgets placement. Something like this. And this. And this. Kivy has only 8 layouts that represent basic schemes of information representation and provide a special behavior. I will show you some of them. The first one, a box layout, that have two states, vertical and horizontal orientations. When box layout is vertically oriented, widgets are automatically placed one under another. And when it is horizontally oriented, its children widgets are placed in a row. Something like that. Or that. And this representation can be implemented with box layout in horizontal orientation. The next one, the grid layout. Grid layout places or aligns its content by a grid. It is very convenient to use in such cases. eShops or portfolios. The next one is a stack layout. Stack layout is somewhat similar to the box layout. It places its children in rows or in columns, as many as they fit there. If a widget does not fit to a row or a column, it will be moved to a new row or a column. The next one is anchor layout. Anchor layout, it fixes a widget in a particular position. A good illustration to its behavior is any top menu or a sidebar. The next one is page layout. It is used when we want to place widgets on several pages, like in tabs, for example. Your mobile devices have much of this. There are also float layout, relative layout, and scatter. Float layout is most similar to absolute positioning of elements in CSS. Its main idea is to set position and size of its children widgets as you like, just by specifying the absolute coordinates and their size. The relative layout is similar to the relative positioning of elements in CSS. I have no pictures because these layouts are simply responsible for positioning the elements and determining their size. They have no special behavior, and I think that the main idea is clear. The build method will return only one main layout widget. That is called the root layout, that contains all other needed widgets or other layouts with widgets. And now I want to place two buttons widgets on a box layout. So I have to import box layout, and here I'm creating an instance of the box layout class, box layout. Then I'm creating an instance of the button class, text equals to hello. The second instance equals to button. And then I want to add widget. And the button 1 as an argument, and again BL and widget button 2. The build method will return BL, the box layout instance. In this case, the build method returns the instance of the box layout class. And the BL, our box layout instance, is the root widget for this application. We can see two buttons that box layout placed according to its default values, that is horizontally, and shared its space between buttons evenly. This way of creation of a user interface is inconvenient and cumbersome. Even with only two buttons and with minimum parameters of each of them. That is why Kivy framework has its own markup Kivy language. The next video will be regarded to Kivy markup language and sizing and positioning of widgets. If you liked the video, please like it and subscribe to the channel.